What is going on, guys? It's Taylor.
And it's your boy, Dre.
Welcome to the edition of Two Guys, One Trailer Reacts, where we do what, Dre?
We're going to check out some trailers to let you know if it's worthwhile. We love checking these out for movies, video games, TV shows, and we love to discuss it. Basically, building some hype for the upcoming show, unless it's trash, which we have on some occasions just pointed out straight trash. And then if we get the chance, we can ruin the story for you. No, I'm just kidding. But we love to try to figure out the mystery, the story, just based on a 60-second to 3-minute trailer. So we're going to do that today, and we'll be checking out Ghostbusters the Frozen Empire, which is a sequel to the what do you call it?
It's not reimagining, it's a reboot, but also it's a continuation.
Call it a soft reboot. I like that. Yeah. Kind of like, it's not really rebooting, but it's revitalizing a series, an IP that's basically been done and done with for at least a decade.
Would you say, like, a fun way of saying, are these trailers popping or flopping?
Here's the thing, and I hate to get political.
Uh-oh.
I hate poppin'? The term, no.
Or flopping.
Flop.
Okay.
Because some of the greatest movies that people will all sit there and agree are some of the best movies ever made were theatrical flops.
All right, how about Smash or Trash?
Smash or Trash, yeah. I get Smash or Trash.
All right, are these trailers Smash or Trash?
Yeah.
Would you literally fuck the trailer? She tracks the trailer, apparently.
Exactly. See that?
There you go. All right.
But one person's, one person's treasures and a person's trash.
no kink shaming here. You want to fuck this trailer? Go ahead. All right. So we're still up in the air about whether we should kind of rebrand our ways of looking at these trailers as far as popping or flopping, trash or smash, or whatever you want. I'm not sure. We'll think it's more funny, stupid things to say.
What we'll do, we'll go like this, and we'll swipe left, I don't remember. Right? You never been on?
My wife might see this. I'm going to tell you that. I'm joking. Swipe left is
on the living swipe right. Okay, yeah. So swipe right is, so we'll do this, and then like the whole thing will swipe right.
How would you swipe on this trailer? Would you invite dinner, or would you tell her to leave?
And they'll go swipe.
It'll be a second date for the trailer.
No. So we have to swipe that. That feels awkward, though. It feels like he's swiping. Anyway.
No, either way, it's fine. All right, we'll take a look at Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. Empire? Is that right?
Like that. Frozen Empire? Question mark?
All right, and play. This is, as it is meant, a continuation.
Anyway, I just assumed it was called Frozen Empire. I'm glad I was right.
Oh, yeah. We watched this right before we played it, and then like it was okay. I guess you can test that to the movie where it was so unforgettable that we watched it and then forgot about the name of it.
I'm just like, man, we put through the whole spiel. I really hope it's the name Frozen Empire. Yeah.
Oh, my.
Hey, let me ask you a question, and this is a question. Did you like the first Ghostbusters Afterlife?
You know, I did enjoy it. I
did or didn't?
I did enjoy it. It was enjoyable. I liked it. I understand situations, you know, Ghostbusters are getting old. They need a new class. And, you know, and we play games like, you know, on our own time. And I know in the Ghostbusters game, you play as a new recruit, and you know, there has to go have a business go on for so long and not have any new recruits is just stupid. Like, not the thought process is like, oh, they're never gonna have any recruits. They won't trust anybody. They have to have people, whether it be forced or by choice.
All right. Well, I'll just let you know. I thought the first movie was not that good. I thought it was a good concept. I was all hyped for it. And then I finally watched it. I was like, this was not what I thought it was.
So this one Frozen.
This feels like this should have been the remake movie.
Well, they had to establish the characters of like who the Ghostbusters were. So now
I think you could have reestablished the characters and still had this week. And this is just all based on the trailer, right? Because this one has a cool core concept of like, this is back. It's scaring people. That I just didn't think I thought the villain of the last movie was
Gozar.
Was terrible.
Gozar was actually
the first villain from the first movie, but the way they brought it out, I just did not think. See, that looks cool. That looks really cool. Like
I'm thinking it's like an ice queen, maybe.
Yeah, it's the chick from Frozen.
It's Elsa doesn't come out.
Dark Elsa,
Anna, or whatever it is. Yeah. I forget.
Dark Anna meets Elsa. I don't know. What are those three? Like, I honestly didn't like the first one. I thought it was like the core concept and the lady or the young lady they played Egon's granddaughter or whatever she was. Perfect. Casting was good. And then I thought the idea of using the plot from the first movie, bringing to a new one, was kind of, at first, it's kind of cliche at this point, because a lot of movies have been doing that. Like the first, like The Force Awakens was basically just a redo of the first Star Wars movie. So that, and I didn't think it was that good. I honestly didn't think it was that good of a movie at all. So I genuinely shocked. Well, okay, take it back. I'm not shocked that they came out with a new one.
Yeah.
Because they need to make money somehow, so they're just going to drain that IP while it's worth.
Yeah.
I just thought they were going to reboot at this point, because I didn't think the first one was that good, honestly. But this one looks to be better to me. So
yep.
I will tell you that while I'm shocked they kept going with it, this one actually looks like it's going to be very good. So I'm looking forward to it.
Yep, I am as well. I do like introducing Patton Oswalt. I want to say Patton Oswalt is probably Patton Oswalt looks to be maybe a
the lore master,
but also but Dan Aykroyd, his character as well as not Spangler, not Egon, but Ray Stantz. I think maybe Ray. Well, Ray owns, in the first movie, you saw Ray owns an occult book store. So I'm thinking that Patton Oswalt works there as well. Kind of, he works there.
What's the dude with the glasses?
Egon.
No. The other dude with the glasses. He worked in like the shop.
Are you talking about the Rick Moranis? About the
he was in a Little Shop of Horrors.
Oh yeah, Rick Moranis. He was a lawyer. So he was Dana's. He was Dana in the first movie. He was Dana's. He lived in the same apartment building as Dana in the complex. Part two, he became a lawyer and he helped him. He helped them in the first part of the movie where he told the judge that he helped one time he turned into a dog and they helped him. Thank you.
Is he still alive?
He's still alive. Yeah. No, he's still alive. It'd be awesome to see him in this movie.
Yeah. That's what I was like. I was wondering why they didn't bring him back, because he was one of the more memorable characters. In fact, when we went to a haunted Halloween show, Halloween Horror Nights, he was there. And if you said a secret word to him, he gave us his card. So I have one of it wasn't the real dude, but it was
okay. No, it was okay.
It was funny to get his card. Like you had to say like a secret code to like Ghostbusters react or Ghostbusters are alive. And he's like, oh yeah, you guys said, and he gave it out. And the dude who was playing was doing a really good version of it. Like, oh, he was very memorable. So
So Rick Moranis is very much alive and well. He actually stopped acting because his wife got sick and passed away. Okay. So he had to. he stopped acting. He lives in Canada currently, sadly, and fuck these people, whoever did this. So he was walking down the street in New York last year, just after and somebody ran up to him and punched him in the face for no fucking reason. Just punched him in the face, and you know, I say fuck those guys, you know, fuck them, and I hope they die horrible deaths. Yeah, Rick Moranis is actually a goddamn national treasure. I say that. We talked about recently in the past 2000 trailer about Honey Blew Up the Kids, Honey the Kids. He was in those movies.
Little Shop of Horrors.
Ryan Reynolds put him in a current. We saw him recently in the newest thing was a Mint Mobile commercial he was part of.
He's part of Mint Mobile. Okay.
Yeah, he did like a guest appearance because Ryan Reynolds is also a very lovable, nice guy, and everybody wants to work with him. So that's why he was in there. But he brings in old things. If you saw, I think the last movie he voiced was Over the Hedge, where it was him and because he used to on SCTV on some Canadian kind of SNL type thing. Bob and Doug, and so he played like two moose. Like it was him and the guy played the same characters played like voiced moose. So that was a quick aside on Rick Moranis.
Okay,
national treasure.
Because I think this will be the point in time where talk about you're the old guard. You're bringing, like you said, you got to bring some new life. You can't have Bill Murray. out here forever. He's gonna, God forbid, pass away eventually. So you need. You want to make a movie before he, you know, dies, before you add him, so you can pass it on, and then
He did ask to die in the he did ask that if they made a new Ghostbusters that he die. So I wonder if they're gonna grant that in this Ghostbusters.
I definitely feel like they're definitely gonna be moving it on to the new guard in this one. I mean, I feel like that's what they're trying to do in the old one, but again, I did not think that was a great
movie. Afterlife.
Yeah, I thought it was a. I thought they got some really good concepts to move it on, but then when I watched the movie, it's like, yeah, this was not what I was expecting. I don't know.
All good.
But they had the podcaster there. That's like the new character, and like in every show, they had like not to say it's all checkboxy, but some characters that have been in a lot of shows is there's a deaf character that signs and stuff.
Yeah.
They always bring that in now to reach out to the hearing impaired, and then they had the podcaster. because it used to be the YouTuber like 20 years ago when they introduced influencers and YouTubers.
Yeah.
Now it's the podcasters they bring into the show. And that was, he was in the last one. So this one, they have to bring in someone who signs. It just has the, anyway.
All good. All right, guys. So that was our look at Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. I was like Frozen Underground. No, Frozen Empire.
You know what we should start doing?
And what's
is,
up?
This is just a thing. We should have
a bingo sign.
We have a bingo card, right? And we'll have bingos and see, like,
oh,
we'll play. We'll
Is this trailer check the boxes?
Yeah, we'll rebrand this to Two Trailers One React Bingo.
Play at home, kids, with us.
And then we'll say, okay, cliche music, check. Character that signed, check. Podcaster, check. And we'll just go through the bingo and see if we get a Two Guys One Trailer Bingo. It'll be fun. I will even create that. So
home version of Two Guys One Trailer Reacts. You can play along with us, kids.
It'll be
have fun.
It'll be a 3x3 square. 25 squares would be too hard to go. So we'll see. We'll see.
Yep. So it'll be called fun or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Something. Right. Yeah. And with one free spot. So that, guys, please thank you and enjoy watching the. Well, I was saying, try it again. All right, guys. On that note, thanks for watching, and we shall see you later.
Peace.